NerdDice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is number 15 in our series, NerdDice Creating a RubyGem. We're going to pick up right where we left off last time, working on the specs for the refresh seed method. So now we'll say with seed arguments supplied, now it needs to be able to handle that. And so we'll work on starting that. So the first thing we're going to do is handle the kernel seed, returning the old seed and using the specified seed. So we'll start here. We'll refactor this later. So there's a lot of repeated code here, but let's just get everything passing first, and then we'll worry about refactoring. All right, so the difference here is that we want a second seed. We'll just switch it around here. The argument that we had, which was random ran new seed. And so we also want to have an expectation about what the seed is after we set this. All right, let's see how that goes. So we're doesn't look like that seed got changed. Let's see what's going on here. So we've got random rand as our method here. And our new seed we're passing in as the value. That looks like what we want should be happening here. But it is not. So look at the first seed, new seed. Thank you. check. So that's returning that. And then so that should be what we experience in our situation here. Going to add a puts statement to make sure that we're getting what we expect here. See what happens there. All right. Let's see if we can find our failure. Seed is okay, so it's setting it with the random ran seed. I might have the argument wrong. Failure. Random ran new seed is not there, so we're not passing it properly. Be dereferencing this properly. Everything is coming. Technique secure random came through. Secure random seed came through. Random ran new seed came through. It would would help if I match my just keep it seed. And pass that as the argument. Right, that I imagine will get us passing. It does. Get rid of the puts statements. And we will implement the random object technique. We'll use the random object here, stick with first seed and new seed being the same. We will first seed, and then we will object seed. And then we'll make an expectation here. If I write expect correctly. Down to 4 pending specs. All right. So in this case, we're going to set both of these values. So we need set the values here, just reverse them to set this. Method. And then make our expectations. Object, random rand, match up the variables correctly here. And assert that both have changed. If this all passes, it does. All right, now we need to handle the three where you specify the randomization techniques. This is going to be fairly easy. We've got random rand here. All right, we'll paste this in. So the only difference is going to be that we change that, get rid of that. Down to two pending. We'll do the same thing for object. this. Down to one pending. Here. Our examples are passing, as you can see here. RuboCop is having an aneurysm, so we do need to go and fix that. The other thing I want to do is I want this method to change the counter. So we're going to have an instance variable counter here back to zero. So we're going to, in our refresh seed item here, sure I'm doing that properly. Colon goes in the other. So, there we go. And then so we'll try this, and in all cases, I'll do an initial setting just to verify that it's changing. Make sure that I've got the again. We're going to want to refactor this. I'll make a separate video for refactoring because it's going to be probably a video's worth of work to get this all done and refactored and into appropriate shared examples as needed and all that stuff. So do that. And we're still passing. So we will stop here and commit what we've got, and then we'll refactor in our next video. Write our message. All right, so we've got our commit message here. All right, we've got our method here. Push it to the remote. And we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching this Stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.